Midday News is brought to you by Dobra A1 Digital Hearing Aid Center, Jammu, offering special discounts for the senior citizens and reimbursement schemes for the government employees.
The Pakistan Army violated the ceasefire thrice on Thursday by resorting to heavy firing and shelling on forward areas and posts in the three sector along the line of control in Poonch area of Jammu and Kashmir. The Pakistani side also resorted to the firing along the international border, targeting helmets and borders outpost in Hiranagar sector of Kathua district overnight. The Indian Army mounted the befitting retaliation. Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh has said that India is destined to play a crucial role in the role post-COVID economy, and bamboo is going to be the pivotal nucleus in the future economic resurgence. Addressing to the national webinar on utilization of bamboo as an alternate fuel resource for cement plants in India, the Union Minister said that it is imperative to give bamboo a pan-India perspective of its growth and utilization. He said, bamboo will be the new fuel of the new engine, that is, Northeast for India's growth story. India's COVID-19 caseload went past 84 lakhs, while the number of people who have recovered from the disease surged to 77.65 lakhs, pushing the national recovery rate to 92.32%, according to the Union Health Ministry data updated on Friday. India's total coronavirus cases mounted to 84,11,724, with 47,638 new infections being reported in a day, while the death toll climbed to 1,24,985, with 670 new fatalities. A total 77,65,966 people have recuperated from COVID-19 so far, pushing the national recovery rate to 92.32%, while the case fatality rate stands at 1.49%. A terrorist was killed in an overnight encounter with the security forces in Pulwama district of Jammu and Kashmir. Security forces launched a cordon and search operation in Nalpora area in Pambor in the South Kashmir district on Thursday. Following information about the presence of terrorists in the area, as search operations was going on, terrorists fired indiscriminately, resulting in the injuries of two persons. The injured persons were rushed to a hospital where they are undergoing treatment. The Andaman and Nicobar Command conducted a three-day joint service exercise code named Bullet Strike at the remotely located Teresa Island. The drill began on Tuesday and ended on Thursday and saw participation from three services, components of the ANC, elements of Indian Army's Parachute Brigade, MARCOS and Special Forces. The exercise focused on enhancing interoperability and synergy amongst the three services, Army, Navy and Air Force, to maximize combat potentials. Jammu and Kashmir on Thursday recorded 524 fresh COVID-19 cases and 6 fatalities linked to the disease in the last 24 hours, bringing the infection count to 97,224 and the death toll to 1,517. Out of the fresh cases, 185 are from Jammu Division and 339 are from the Kashmir Valley. Srinagar District recorded a maximum of 155 new cases, followed by 99 in Jammu. The Union Territory has 5,802 active cases of the novel coronavirus, while 89,905 patients have recovered so far. Jammu and Kashmir government has evacuated 7,93,094 JK residents stranded in the other parts of the country due to the COVID lockdown via Lakhanpur and through special trains and buses till date amidst the strict observance of all necessary guidelines and standard operating procedures. As per the official data received in this regard, the Jammu and Kashmir administration has received 155 special trains at Jammu and Udhampur railway station from different states and UTs so far, with about 1,40,292 passengers, while about 6,52,802 people from other states and UTs, including 937 from abroad, have been evacuated by the government through Lakhanpur till date. Advisor to the Lieutenant Governor, Basir Ahmed Khan, on Thursday met different delegations from Agra Industries, Shopian Travel and Trade, Joint Amalgamation of 20 Organizations of Trade, Kashmir, and FCI Kashmir at SKICC Srinagar. Advisor held a threadbare discussion with all delegations and deliberated over the issues and demands raised by them during the series of the meetings. Advisor Basir Khan assured the visiting deputations that all these genuine issues would be examined for the early redness. He also issued the spot directions to the concerned officer to take cognizance of issues pertaining to their departments. The training of general and expenditure observers deployed for DDC elections, Panchayat by Elections and Municipal by Elections 2020 was held at the office of the Chief Electoral Officer, Nirvachan Bhavan. The officers from Kashmir Division attended the training through the virtual mode from Srinagar CEO office. The State Election Commissioner K.K. Sharma and Chief Electoral Officer J.N.K. Hirdesh Kumar gave a detailed briefing to the participants about their duties and responsibilities in the election. Accusing the Democrats of stealing the elections, US President Donald Trump on Thursday claimed that as per the legal vote count, he easily wins. The US President mentioned that there was no big blue wave as the pollsters had predicted. Instead, there was a big red wave. According to the CNN, Democratic presidential candidate Joe Biden has managed to hold a 40-point lead over the President Donald Trump on Thursday.